relationship to Christ, God's love for men. Nature and revelation alike testify of God's love. Our Father in heaven is the source of life, of wisdom, and of joy. Look at the wonderful and beautiful things of nature. Think of their marvelous adaptation to the needs and happiness not only of men, but of all living creatures. The sunshine and the rain that gladden and refresh the earth, the hills and seas and plains, all speak to us of the Creator's love. It is God who supplies the daily needs of all His creatures. In the beautiful words of the psalmist, "The eyes of all wait upon Thee, and Thou givest them their meat in due season. Thou openest Thy hand, and satisfiest the desire of every living thing." Psalm 145 verses 15 and 16. God made man perfectly holy and happy, and the fair earth, as it came from the Creator's hand, bore no blight of decay or shadow of the curse. It is transgression of God's law, the law of love, that hath brought woe and death. Yet, amid the suffering that results from sin, God's love is revealed. It is written that God cursed the ground for man's sake. Genesis 3 verse 17. The thorn and the thistle, the difficulties and trials that make his life one of toil and care, were appointed for his good as a part of the training needful in God's plan for his uplifting from the ruin and degradation that sin has wrought. The world, though fallen, is not all sorrow and misery. In nature itself are messages of hope and comfort. There are flowers upon the thistle, and the thorns are covered with roses. Step to Christ, page 9.